సైన్సెస్ రంగంలో మన దేశంలో హైదరాబాద్ రాజధానిగా మారిందని మంత్రి కేటీఆర్ అన్నారు. భాగ్యనగరంలో లైఫ్ సైన్స్ పరిశ్రమ సర్వేగంగా అభివృద్ధి చెందుతోందని చెప్పారు. హైదరాబాద్ సుల్తాన్పూర్లోని మెడికల్ డివైస్ పార్క్లో ఏర్పాటు చేసిన ఆకృతి ఐ కేర్ మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చరింగ్ యూనిట్ను కేటీఆర్ ప్రారంభించారు. మేక్ ఇన్ ఇండియాలో భాగంగా తెలంగాణలోని వైద్య పరికరాలను తయారు చేసేందుకు గాను ఈ మెడికల్ డివైస్ పార్క్ ఉపయోగపడనుంది. అందులో ఏర్పాటు చేసిన ఆకృతి ఐ కేర్ మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చరింగ్ యూనిట్ వల్ల ఎంతో మందికి ఉపాధి దొరకనుంది. ఆకృతికి 15 సంవత్సరాల అపారమైన అనుభవం ఉంది. విజన్ థెరపీ, ఆక్యులోప్లాస్టీ, పీడియాట్రిక్ ఆప్థమాలజీ తదితర విభాగాలకు సంబంధించిన పరికరాలను ఇది ఉత్పత్తి చేస్తుంది.
I remember standing here and addressing the leaders of the medtech industry on this very own campus during the inauguration in 2017, exactly 4 years ago. Firmly believe that this would have materialized much sooner but for COVID. But nevertheless, it's a matter of great pride and also great pleasure that in just a span of few years, this park has taken up so well and has already become one of the leading and most attractive research and development and manufacturing destinations for the medical devices companies. And this, as I said, despite the setbacks faced by the industry and entrepreneurs during the unprecedented COVID period. Since its launch, the park has received an overwhelming response, with about 50 companies setting up their manufacturing and R&D units, with an overall investment of ₹1,424 crores and a total employment potential of 7,000 direct jobs and at least twofold that indirect. I congratulate all the 7 companies on this occasion who have inaugurated their facilities. My compliments to all of you entrepreneurs. We are committed to promoting research, development, innovation and manufacturing in this segment. Medical Devices Park is indeed a very important initiative of the government of Telangana, which underscores not only our intent to leverage the promising potential of the industry for the state, but also to reduce dependency on countries' imports. This park also reinforces the government's commitment to strengthen the state's manufacturing capabilities, which going forward will help attract even greater investments in a broad range of medical device product segments, ranging from capital equipment, implantable devices, diagnostics, and consumables. We aim to make this park as not just a global factory for the world, but a global medtech innovation ecosystem. The red hot life sciences industry has seen an incredible growth in the last 2 years as a response to the pandemic crisis. As the biomedical and diagnostics revolution has gained traction world over, key discoveries ranging from the development of engineered modified RNA technology, which enabled rapid development of effective COVID-19 vaccine, to bioprosthetic implants, to at-home genetic testing kits, to cardiac diagnostic tools, to handheld ultrasound devices, to mobile ventilators, to oxygen concentrators, to personal protection equipment and all other medical supplies, have propelled growth and investment in this sector. During this period of tremendous growth in both the Indian economy and its healthcare sector, coupled with availability of skilled human resource and low operation costs, it is critical time to capitalize on the opportunities in the medical devices sector available within India and particularly the MedTech Park of Hyderabad. The comprehensive and vibrant multidisciplinary ecosystem of Hyderabad clearly differentiates the city from the rest of the country. While there are more than 20 innovation centers in Hyderabad, the government has also established the country's largest prototyping facility called as T-Works to support the development activities and enable the manufacturing activity at the medical devices park. In addition, Hyderabad has numerous companies with expertise in plastics, precision engineering, electronics, etc., all of which are extremely vital for the medical device innovators and manufacturers. As a natural outcome, the city is making rapid strides in redefining healthcare for India. We need to help these companies innovate and develop products that are more advanced, efficient, and most importantly, affordable. We also have to help companies build products that are relevant to our region, thereby helping to reduce imports. It is in this context, our focus is not only helping the medtech industry establish their manufacturing centers, but also supporting innovation and research and development, which will ultimately lead to large-scale manufacturing. And hence, we have adopted an end-to-end approach for promoting growth in this sector, with large thrust on promoting design and development of innovative medical devices. I'm also very excited to state today that Hyderabad has become a hotbed for medtech innovation. A few months back, I had the pleasure of inaugurating the largest research and development center outside of the United States of America for a company called Medtronic, which serves as a testimony to Hyderabad's growing prowess for medtech research in India. I'm also happy to note that the center has already started making its impact by making significant contributions to the development and testing for robotic-assisted surgery system, and also in the development of simplified and remotely deployable solutions that can help physicians monitor the vital parameters of their patients no matter where they are in the world, thus ensuring safety and minimizing clinical exposure. A range of companies and startups based in Hyderabad are focused on building next-generation medical device products such as 3D printed bionic arms, imaging systems, digital health solutions, mobile dialysis units, next generation stents, targeted delivery devices, implants, among others. These startups and companies are taking a variety of approaches to innovating in the medical device industry, and they continue to put Hyderabad on the innovation global map. And the Medical Devices Park offers complementary support to these innovators and companies as they scale up. The kind of investments and establishments in this space that Hyderabad has witnessed in the last 4 years, not only from local but also from global companies, has been extremely overwhelming and gratifying. I would also like to highlight that B. Braun, a leading medical devices company in the world, headquartered in Germany, has invested more than rupees 100 crores in the state and currently employs more than 550 people with focus on producing world-class quality products in the portfolio of infusion therapy, comprising of hypodermic syringes and needles. I hope that the association between the state of Telangana and D. Brown only grows stronger in future. And today, I'm delighted and honored to be inaugurating 7 companies of med devices, as I pointed out. Chromia Therapeutics, Huvel Life Sciences, Akriti, Oculoplasty, Arca Engineers, SVP, Techno Engineers, LVCon, and Reese Medilife. I'm happy to note that these companies have proposed total investment of about 265 crores and the employment generation of almost 1,300 direct jobs. I would like to highlight that Chromia Therapeutics is slated to be one of the biggest IV fluids and bags manufacturing facilities in the country, with a production capacity of 5 million bottles and bags a month. Chromia is also one of the largest fully integrated in vitro diagnostic manufacturing facilities, with capabilities to manufacture novel molecular kits such as triplex RT-PCR for HIV, hepatitis B, and hepatitis C, and routine parameters for ELISA, rapid tests, biochemistry and hematology used in every lab. Altogether, more than 100 different diagnostic products coming just from one Chromia. In the near future, Chromia will also be launching a 25,000 instrument division to develop point-of-care devices and analyzers used in diagnostic labs. Huvel Life Sciences is engaged in manufacturing of molecular diagnostics, lateral flow, rapid antigen antibody kits with the capacity to produce 3 million tests a month. The company will also manufacture room temperature stable reagents, which enable transportation and storage of RT-PCR kits at room temperatures. It is a matter of great significance that this company, Huvel Life Sciences, manufactures all the components in-house, which include enzyme primers and probes, which are extremely helpful in effective implementation of RT-PCR tests in Tier 2 and Tier 3 towns. Arca will be manufacturing dental implants, maxillofacial implants, custom-designed prosthesis, cranial 3D plating systems, and R&D in bone grafts, etc. SVP engineers will be manufacturing linear motion and automation products, solutions like continuous passive motion equipment, medical bathing system, and robotic gait training system. All of these, again, coming from this medical devices park. LVCon will be manufacturing 3D printed implants and health parameter monitoring motoring technologies and sensors, while Akriti will be manufacturing a range of high-end ocular implants and a range of ophthalmic devices. Reese Medilife will also produce various sterilized wound dressing surgical kits, among others. In addition to many other facilities, Asia's largest stent manufacturing facility will also be set up by Sahajanand Medical Technologies, which will be inaugurated in a couple of months, and I'm sure I'll come back for that inauguration as well. I would also like to take this opportunity to request all of these companies and also other companies who are in the process of setting up labs and units in the medtech park to strive to move up the value chain. Let's nurture the ecosystem to manufacture high quality medical devices and compete with the world. I'd like to take this opportunity to request these companies all to ensure that we continue to innovate as we move forward. These developments will continue to keep Hyderabad map, on the innovation map, on the medtech map, and we are also on course. In fact, we had set an ambitious goal for ourselves. Right now, as of 2020, Hyderabad's life sciences ecosystem is valued at $50 billion. We had set a very ambitious goal for ourselves that we will double this to $100 billion in a matter of 10 years by 2030. And I'm very confident with a complete life sciences spectrum, starting from bulk drugs, pharmaceuticals, biotechnology, to vaccine manufacturing, to medical devices, to Hyderabad Pharma City. The entire life sciences industry in Hyderabad and its future looks very, very good. Jai Telangana.